deaths, newest icon, and setting the stage for major black-on-white violence next time around, and minor black-on-white violence many more times around, in whatever pretext they take. We've gone in the last week or so from Trayvon Martin as the latest version of Sandra Fluke or Warren Buffett's secretary. We've gone from there into iconic Che Guevara territory. And could anyone have come up with anything that would make the official black leftist establishment party line seem less credible, more unconcerned with truth and with actual facts, and just plain incapable of coexisting in a republic? Could even Nathan Bedford Forrest, the founder of the Ku Klux Klan, have come up with a creature as grotesque as Al Sharpton? Okay, the Obama regime and those who put him in power want us to talk about Trayvon Martin to distract us from the economy, from gas prices, and from the ever-surging global caliphate. But we're not going to further indulge that topic at this time. Welcome to the High 95 Radio Hour on WWDB 860 AM in Philadelphia and streaming on the web at WWDBAM.com. I'm your host, Adam Paxson, and this show ties into the High95.com website. That's CHAI95.com. And yes, that name is a pun on the highway I-95, because after all, what we're trying to offer with our limited resources is, from Maine to Miami, news and views that Jews with clues can use. But with apologies to our fans in places like Maine and Miami, we're really going to be focused today on our home base in southeastern Pennsylvania, since the Keystone State's primary, which is particularly important this year because of the nail in Rick Santorum's coffin in his home state factor, because that is exactly 3 weeks away from today. We're going to be talking to an airline pilot in Marine veteran Joe Rooney, who is challenging the stereotypical Jewish far-left Obama rubber stamp, but strong on Israel, Congresswoman Allison Schwartz. And then we're going to speak with Roger Howard, a local Republican state Senate candidate, challenging the entrenched business-as-usual Pennsylvania GOP establishment figure Dominic Pileggi. But before that, a few words about a book that was released just this morning. Today is the official release date for Michael Savage's Trickle Down Tyranny, Crushing Obama's Dream of the Socialist States of America. The city of Philadelphia's one remaining Barnes & Noble opened at 8 a.m. this morning, and I had paid for a copy by 8:03 a.m. I don't make much of a secret that Michael Savage is my favorite radio host. He's also the most popular Jewish radio host in the world. I don't make much of a secret that his fearlessness is quite an inspiration to me. And Michael Savage makes no secret of the fact that he is ignored and essentially blacklisted, not only by the so-called mainstream media which this week reached even lower depths with, let me get back to it, even though I said I wouldn't, with the revelation of that it had been doctoring both audio and video of George Zimmerman. But not only the so-called mainstream media pretends he doesn't exist, but the conservative media does, and that includes Fox, Rush Limbaugh, etc. In fact, some actively talk trash about him, Mark Levin and Dennis Prager, over the last few weeks in particular. So the blackout of a very important, very independent broadcaster is why I'm trying to do my part to bring just a bit more attention to his important book. And about that book, Dr. Savage, who has, by the way, written, you know, some refer to him as a shock jock. He's written about 25 books to date. He says it will be the last nonfiction book he ever writes, and that's in part because he has very serious concerns about the freedom of the press during Obama's likely second term. From the extremely limited time I've had so far to look at trickle-down tyranny, it's a sobering wake-up call. It seems not so much like a labor of love that he enjoyed writing, but more of a labor of duty. And Dr. Savage's labor of duty is occurring during what he says, and I agree with this, a de facto clamping down on freedom of speech. In other words, publishers and radio stations are really feeling terrified these days of giving conservatives a voice. The book is of the I'm mad as hell and I'm not going to take it anymore mindset. So, you know, some of the chapter titles give you an idea of what the book's about. It includes Tyranny of the Government Media Complex, Tyranny of Treating Our Friends Like Enemies and our enemies like friends, and that's for us, fellow Israel supporters. Tyranny of green energy, tyranny of the anti-justice department. And while I've read a little way into the book, Dr. Savage's first paragraph or so does, well, what a first paragraph should do. It sets a tone. Let me read it. The chapter one is called Advice to the New President, a Savage Worldview. And it reads, economies can be rebuilt, armies can be repopulated, but once a nation's pride is gone, it can almost never be restored. The loss of a nation's honor is something not even centuries can repair. The next president must love America. The next president must embody unequivocally everything that is good about this country going back to its founding. The next president must be the exact opposite of Barack Obama. Dr. Savage then provides specific advice for what the next Republican presidential candidate should say, and which Dr. Savage said on his show yesterday will be less likely to be followed by the Romney campaign than the advice that Van Jones, perhaps not even that seriously, gave while on the Sunday morning big media talk show circuit. So you get the idea. Pick up a copy of Trickle Down Tyranny. It's now on sale. I'll be reading it over Passover, which starts Friday night, although who knows, I may even be done it by then. Anyhow, let me welcome in studio Bob Guzzardi, my co-host today, and the editor of the Liberty Blog, which can be found at thelibertyblog.org. Bob, welcome.
Thank you. The convention...